Hi, I'm Cody from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll show you how to build a segment. You'll learn how to target a specific portion of your audience so that you can personalize your messaging for your contacts' needs. All right, let's get started. First, I'm gonna head to Audience and choose Segments. To help you get going, we offer pre-built segments with some of our recommended targeting options. You can access the full list by clicking View All Pre-built Segments. These are available on all plan types. You can use them without making any changes, but they're also customizable. You should know that some conditions and advanced segmentation features are only available on certain plan types, but I'll start by showing you a segment available to everyone. For this example, I'm going to set up a segment targeting new subscribed contacts who I want to make a purchase at the Potted Planter. That's a fictitious flower shop we made for teaching purposes. And I'll send it to customers who live near my store. So let's take a look at the new subscribers pre-built segment. By default, this includes all contacts who signed up for your marketing within the last 7 days. If that doesn't work for you, go ahead and adjust the segment filters as necessary. I'll change this to 14 days. Next, I'll click Add Filter to further specify which contacts I want to include in this segment. Let's say for this example, I know marigolds are popular with my new contacts. I'm going to craft an email that has helpful information about how to grow them and includes a call to action to come in and buy some. For the best results, I'm only going to send this email to subscribed contacts who I know love marigolds. In order to do that, I'll click the filter menu and select or search for tags. Next, I'll make sure contact is tagged is selected, and then I'll search for the tag that I want to work with. I have a field in my signup form for people to tell me which flowers they like best, and I've already set up tags to help me filter my contacts by those shared interests. So, for this one, I'll enter the name Marigold Fans. All right, let's add one more filter. I want to make sure I'm only sending to subscribed contacts who live near my store. So again, I'll click Add Filter, then I'll search for predicted location, and there it is. Click that, and then select Is Within, and then enter a location. I'll use Atlanta, Georgia. Then select Validate Location, and if that looks right, select Use This Location. Now there's one more thing I need to cover. Before I finish setting this up, I need to select the logic for my conditions. Basically, this determines if you want the contacts included here to meet one or all of the filters that you have set. Or means any. So to be included in the segment, a contact would meet at least one of the conditions. And means all the conditions need to be met to be included in the segment. Now, depending on your plan, you might not be able to combine and or logic within a segment. With that in mind, we'll keep this example simple and select and for the top level logic. Now our segment only includes contacts who have been added in the last 14 days and who are tagged as Marigold fans and who live near my store. Perfect. I'll go ahead and click Review Segment. This screen shows me how many contacts meet the segmentation criteria I just set. And I can scroll down to see some examples. If everything looks good, click Use Segment, give it a name, and click Save and Exit. Nice! Now I can select this segment when I craft my email. All right, you've got the basics. Now let's try an advanced segment available on one of our higher tier marketing plans. Advanced segmentation allows you to combine and or logic and create different combinations of data you've collected, like engagement or purchase activity. So for this example, I'm going to target Rose fans near my store who haven't made a purchase in a while. And for the best results, I'm only going to send this email to my engaged customers. I can start building from the same page we began our last example by clicking Create Segment, or I can build it from the email checklist. I'll go ahead and create an email to show you how. And I'll call this Rose Winback. And in the To field, I'll select my audience. Then in the Send To dropdown, I'll go to Actions and click Target Segment. Now we're in the Segment Builder. I'll start by adding a filter for predicted location is within 25 miles and type my store location, Atlanta, Georgia. Then validate location, use this location. Next, I'll click Add And to add another filter. I'll click Tags. And let's make sure we have Contact is Tagged selected. And then type Rose Fans. Our next filter is going to be another And Logic filter. I'll scroll down to E-commerce Activity section and select Purchase Activity. Now we'll select Has Purchased. Then for time frame, I'll find is not within and enter the last 240 days. Now, there are a lot of other options here, but for this example, we'll just leave those as the defaults. Keep in mind that you'll need to have a store connected to Mailchimp and e-commerce tracking turned on to target customers based on their purchase activity. Next, we'll add the engagement filter. I'll click Add And. Then scroll to the Email, SMS, and Automations Activity section and select Email Engagement. And remember, you can also search for a condition instead of scrolling. I'll select Is, and then Often. This segment now includes all contacts who live near my store and are tagged as Rose fans and have not recently made a purchase and often engage with my emails. Now we're getting pretty specific. So let's go ahead and set this up so that we're also including contacts who only sometimes engage with my emails. To do that, I'll click Add Or. Now, all of these next conditions below the Or logic statement will be nested together, creating a second set of contacts that will be included in my targeting. Here, I'll set up the same first three filters I already created above. So, predicted location is within 25 miles of Atlanta, Georgia, and tags Rose fans and purchase activity is not within the last 240 days. Now we'll add the fourth and filter. Email engagement is, but this time we're going to select sometimes. Now we're including more contacts in our targeting and still filtering out those who aren't very engaged. We'll click Review Segment, and now you can see the two groups of contacts who meet the conditions we've set. You won't be able to save segments built from the email checklist, so if you'd like to reuse the segment you've just built, you'll want to navigate back to the Segments page in the Audience tab, click Create Segment, and then you can recreate all of the filters and logic, and then save. All right, great job! Now you know enough to explore more of our segmentation options on your own. For next steps, I recommend that you build some segments that are specific to your business. You could start with one of our pre-built segments for some inspiration. And if you have more questions on segmentation, please visit MailChimp.com/help. Thanks, y'all.